they're getting along, those little boys. Here, boys.
Once again,
the girls.
Oh,
everyone's attention, please. I am Mark Bowen from Philip. I teach K-12 band and vocal in the Philip School District, and I am also the South Dakota Music Education Association Awards Chair. Each year, SDMEA presents teachers who have given years of service to the students of South Dakota. They are presented a plaque in recognition for 25 years of service, 30, 35, and we have a 40 once again this year. So at this time, I would like my 25-year award winners to come out front, and I will announce their names, and they'll give you a little wave, and if you wait till the end so we can give them all of the 25 years a round of applause for their years of service. I have Lynn Alberti of West Middle School in Rapid City, Dr. Lisa Greves of Augustana College in Sioux Falls, 25 years, Kay Herbold, Centerville School District, Julie Mier.
Performing in tonight's concert have had months of hard work and preparation before arriving in Sioux Falls.
and have spent the past 2 days in intense rehearsals to perform for you this evening. I know you will enjoy tonight's concert as a performance of Dakota's top choral and orchestral students. While you enjoy the concert, please remember that in addition to the skills that students demonstrate, music education helps prepare young people to think creatively, learn how to work collaboratively, and become disciplined critical thinkers and problem solvers. In short, music education orchestrates success. We'd like to thank the All-State Chorus and Orchestra Committees and Chairs of the NAFME members for helping with this event over the weekend. We also wish to thank the staff at Sioux Falls Arena and Convention Center for their help in ensuring the success of this event. This time it is my pleasure to welcome the Orchestra Chairperson, Carla Schrill.
great weekend making some fantastic music here with about 1,000 young singers and a fabulous conductor. Cannot wait for you to hear the amazing music that we've been able to create over the last 2 days. I'd like to take this time to make some thank yous, to make this Allstate Chorus truly a fantastic event. First, I'd like to thank our site chair, Robin Starks Holcomb, and her helper, Stephen Brand, for all their help making things happen. I'd also like to thank my committee members, Tricia Fisher, Sherry Holt, Elizabeth Gould, Angela Larson, Kristen Smelling, Colby Shuck, Darlene Fett, and Ann Deckard. I'd also like to thank our amazing accompanist that we've been working with for the last couple of days, Ms. Deanna Wurzbach. The order of tonight's program is a bit different, so I'm going to go ahead and explain the changes in our program. Our first number tonight is going to be The King Shall Rejoice by Handel. The second piece is Lord of the Small, and we have a couple of narrators on that piece, Willow Cowherd and Seth Gerberding. Then our third number will be Beautiful City, and we'll be joined on drums by Brendan Lear and Abby Simmons on the bass guitar. Our fourth selection will be De Profundis, which is a premiere of this piece that was written for this particular ensemble. What an honor that is to premiere that this evening. Our fifth piece is Donna Say by Mr. Raymond Wise, who will also be joining us on the keyboard tonight. You can read his full bio and all sorts of great information about him in your insert in your program. It truly has been a magnificent weekend here. Donna Say has a bunch of people joining us. We'll have the entire percussion section from the Allstate Orchestra joining us. And then we have some soloists as well. Braden Cricket, Valerie Sunderland, and Richard Rigman will be joining us on solos. And finally, our sixth number tonight is Nyan Nyan. I'd like to, at this time, to introduce to you our fabulous conductor, Dr. Andre Thomas. Thank you.
Erin was diagnosed with neuroblastoma at the age of 5. During the next 7 years, she endured chemotherapy, surgery, 2 stem cell transplants, radiation, and 8 experimental tumor vaccines. Her various treatments never dampened her enthusiasm for life.
One of Erin's preschool teachers told the family, "Erin is my favorite child to read to. All of the children listen, but she always listens like she means it." Erin lived the way she listened, completely and delightfully attuned to the moment. Erin was an unapologetic enthusiast. Some flames burn long, yet dim. Others burn quickly, but despite the brevity, burn all the more brightly. May we all live life as Erin did. Lord of the Small.
Souls. the world and through music history. We began with a piece that was written 300 years ago, this very month, for the coronation of King George I, the second in England. That was written by the great composer Handel. We then proceeded from that to an American composer, a very vibrant American composer, writing prolifically now in our country by the name of Dan Forrest, written about the Texan small child who was dying. And then we took you to a beautiful city, which takes us to what we call in America, as Langston Hughes says, it is amazing out of man's inhumanity to man, it should come forth America's greatest art form. That form of the Negro spiritual, of course, is what he's referring to, and you heard a little bit of that in the beautiful city. Then we took you to the piece that was written specifically for this choir. It was composed by the Polish composer Frederick Chopin. And the setting, of course, is made on the De Profundis text from the Book of Psalms. Now we take you to the west coast of Africa.
We look like we're ready to go to the west coast of Africa, don't we? All the drums are ready to go.
We're going to the west coast. And to travel, that's called the Gold Coast often of Africa, and that's where many of the slaves were taken from. Traveling down from Senegal and into the great country of Ghana, this piece comes from. This is Danase.
Oh,
is a difficult one. And if I would program it for this all state, my first reaction was, no way. And he says, oh, trust me, trust me, trust me, trust me. It's a very difficult piece. They're going to be making all kinds of chords and sounds, 9s, 11s, and 13s. They're going to be demonstrating to you a technique that's done on the radio called beatboxing. You hear the basses go, the piece is gun. It means absolutely nothing. It's all nonsense syllables. It's usually done with a smaller chorus. You know, somewhere around 24, 26. We're just going to blow the waters out with 1,000 voices singing Donna Say. This is my second time conducting this wonderful choir. It was 20 years ago in Rapid City when I conducted this choir in 1994. And there was a wonderful young man in that choir. His name is Chris, and he's now the organizing chair for this year's choir. So I told Chris, I said, you know, I'm getting pretty old now, and if you invite me on a 20-year cycle, I'll be 82 by the time I get back. I am so proud. I'm talking so they can get moved. Because moving 1,000 people is not easy.
All right, he's right back
there. Yeah, we're still moving.
He's over there, yeah.
Not only has this piece tested our ability
to hear and
intonation, but more explicitly, it has tested whether or not there is rhythm. This is my second concert this year with high school students. By the end of April, I will have seen 5,000 students across the United States. Second time back to...
Yeah.
sounded for professional choirs and community choirs throughout the entire country. And every 2 years or so, they commission a piece that will, the sole benefits from this piece go to help fund the course of error. And fortunately, or unfortunately, it was my turn to be the commission composer. And the result was over 28 courses combined together and contributed $13,000 for these 3 minutes that you're about to hear. Unfortunately, none of that money goes to me. But Neil Lorenz, who lives in Ohio, wrote these beautiful words about young people. And I said, Neil, I want you to write a piece that is something that's close to my heart. And there's nothing closer to my heart than young people. Because I firmly believe, as long as we have young people, we have a future. We have a great future. And standing in front of me, 1,000 singers that are going to just take this world. And if the orchestra world is blessed enough to have these folks, we have a contribution to make. The text says, someday is today. It's not tomorrow. It's not later on when we make up our mind that we're going to have a better world. We're going to have a better world today. Someday is today.
By me. Playing a song by them.
Someday is today.
Yes, and thank you, buddy, for letting me come back again.
Thank you.
now my pleasure to conclude the 2014 South Dakota All-State Boys Orchestra. If I could please have the audience hang tight for just a moment as we excuse the orchestra first and then following the choir. We meet your children out front of the lobby. Thank you so much. We wish you Steve Campbell Hall, and we hope to see you in the 2015 All-State in Rapid City, South Dakota. Thank you.